Life Audio.
Welcome to the Crosswalk Devotional. We're glad to have you listening. Today's topic is thankfulness. We'll return with the devotional after a brief message from one of our sponsors.
Providing for your family is a top priority. But what happens when you need affordable health care? Christian Healthcare Ministries could save you up to 40% today. As a member, you can choose your provider without network restrictions. Sign up at your convenience with our anytime enrollment. Join a Christian community that supports each other's medical expenses, offering peace of mind as you prioritize what's most important. Enroll now at yourchm.org.
Anticipated rock holiday tradition returns. Trans-Siberian Orchestra live in concert, coming to a city near you. A legendary blend of rock, classical, and holiday music for the entire family. Don't miss Trans-Siberian Orchestra live in concert. The Ghosts of Christmas Eve. Go to tsotickets.com for info.
The Essence of Thankfulness by Meg Booker, read by Leah Martin. I once thought these things were valuable, but now I consider them worthless because of what Christ has done. Philippians 3:7. The mint green box with flowers on it collects all the dust bunnies under the bed. Its contents are the memories of a season of life. We attach sentiment to things on this earth, things become especially meaningful to us when they symbolize something much greater than the craving for the physical object. It's sad to box up a season of life you once treasured. Paul wrote to the Philippians about the true value of things. The Greek for things is hostis, and the word is defined as whoever, whatever, who. One of the definitions for things in the English language is anything that is or may become an object of thought. Our earthly selves love to be loved and comfortable. We love the assurance that someone will never leave us and slowly forget that there's only one who never will. The New Life Translation Bible notes explain that when Paul speaks of these things, he's referring to his credentials, his credits, and successes after showing that he could beat the Judaizers at their own game of being proud of who they were and what they had done. Paul shows that it's the wrong game. Be careful of considering your position or past achievements so important that they get in the way of your relationships with Christ. Add to achievements are relationships, and how tempting it is to hold people to standards in this life that they can never fulfill for us. Paul continued to write, "Yes, everything else is worthless when compared with the infinite value of knowing Christ Jesus, my Lord." Philippians 3:8. Christ Jesus is the only one who can fill the gaps in our human hearts, which automatically ache for assurance, comfort, and companionship. Everything and everyone will fail to fulfill this desire in our lives because our hearts were created to crave Him. The Moody Bible Commentary explains, gaining Christ is described in three ways. First, it's found in Him. Second, it's not having one's own righteousness. Third, it's having the righteousness which comes through faith in Christ. The author of Hebrews reminds us, "Now faith is confidence in what we hope for and assurance about what we do not see." Hebrews 11:1. Paul wrote to the Romans, "For in the gospel, the righteousness of God is revealed, a righteousness that is by faith from first to last, just as it is written, the righteous will live by faith." Romans 11:17. The desire to put our hope in whoever or whatever ends up in a box collecting the dust bunnies under our beds. Our souls were created to put our hope in one person, Christ Jesus. Through Him, we come to the Father. In Him, we find peace, joy, love, and purpose By his death, we get to live ours to the full here on earth and eternally with him in heaven. Paul continued, "For his sake I have discarded everything else, counting it all as garbage, so that I could gain Christ and become one with him. I no longer count on my own righteousness through obeying the law. Rather, I become righteous through faith in Christ. For God's way of making us right with himself depends on faith." Philippians 3:8b through 9. Intersecting faith and life. Faith isn't an object we own or a level we achieve in life. Faith is a living and breathing part of who we are, constantly being molded into the image of Christ Jesus as we follow him through our daily lives. Paul's letter continued, "I want to know Christ and experience the mighty power that raised him from the dead. I want to suffer with him, sharing in his death, so that one way or another I will experience the resurrection from the dead." Philippians 3:10-11. Though it seems some seasons in our lives are unrelatably painful, Christ gets it. The box of memories collecting dust bunnies means something to him because it means something to us. God doesn't meet us with a pep talk. He meets us with compassion. He says, "Let's go through this box together. Bring it to me." He sees us, he knows us, and he longs to comfort us in the times we need to remember this truth the most. Whoever or whatever is nothing in comparison to the complete peace, restoration, love, and joy we experience in Christ Jesus. No thing, nothing, compares to who he is. Let's pray. Father, you're so faithful. Every day your mercies are new. Great is your faithfulness. We can be sad and we can cry out to you, God. Thank you for who you are. Your compassion saves our lives over and over again. We confess our misplacement of people and things in our lives. We confess our focus on achieving over abiding in you. We love you with our whole hearts. Help us to understand how to grow in our love for you. Let it overflow out of our lives and onto everyone around us, Father. Amen. The Crosswalk Devotional is a production of Life Audio and Salem Media. If you liked what you heard today, please take a second to rate and review this podcast in your favorite podcast app so that more listeners like you can find the show. For more faith-filled, inspirational podcasts, visit us at lifeaudio.com.
Do you live, work, or play in downtown Baltimore? The Charm City Circulator goes everywhere you want to go downtown. And best of all, it's free. So let us take you there. Visit charmcitycirc.com. That's charmcitycirc.com.